One of the keys to success is taking action. Today we're going to discuss the law of inspired action. Hello again, everybody. I'm Eli's dad with Project Eli, where we educate, lead, and inspire. This will be the fifth law of the universe that we're going to discuss. Quick review, because these laws are all connected and it's essential that you grasp that they're all connected in order to expedite your journey to reach the promised land. All right, the very first law that we talked about was the divine law of oneness. That is tells us that everything is connected, that we are connected to the universe is inside all of us. Second was the law of vibration. The law of vibration tells us that everything is energy, and that when thoughts are things, and that when you have a thought, you're sending out some energy into the universe. The third, it was the law of correspondence. And the law of correspondence tells us that the outer world is nothing more than a reflection of the inner world. So what you think, what you're thinking in here, what you, the story that you tell yourself, is what you're going to see 360 degrees all around you. And once you change that, your inner story, then the outside will change. But before you can change the outside, first you have to change the inside. Then of course is the law of attraction, and I have a very lengthy video on the law of attraction. And of course, you know, most people know about the law of attraction, where like attracts like. And now we come to the law of inspired action. The law, and one of the things that, because some people, they get the law of attraction, but they don't take any action. The law of inspired action helps you, but it's part of the law of attraction. You have to understand it. It's critical. Here's the way it works. When you're thinking about a particular subject, when you're thinking about a particular goal, a dream, an ambition, you're sending out certain vibes. And one of the things that happens, now Napoleon Hill calls it the sixth sense. Here what's calling it the law of inspired action. What happens is the universe, once again, the universe is inside all of us. We're all part of the same deal. We're all connected. The universe wants to help you achieve your goals. Problem: we think over 60,000 thoughts every single day. How does the universe differentiate that one special dream, that one burning desire that you have, from your casual thoughts? Well, what happens is when you are thinking that thought and focusing on that thought and have singleness of purpose on that thought, then the universe is able to differentiate that thought from the other 60,000 thoughts or so that you think every single day. The universe wants to become your partner. However, the universe will not remain your partner for very long unless you take action. Once you take action on your singleness of purpose, on your burning desire, that alerts the universe. It says, hey, I'm very serious about this. This is something that I want. And the key thing you have to understand is that the universe does not make judgments, doesn't say that's a good thing, that's a bad thing, I'm going to help him with this, I'm not going to help him with that. The universe does not make judgments. The universe is not the Supreme Court. What the universe does is it acts, it's a law, so that, once again, if you have an apple, you drop it, it always falls down. If you have a particular burning desire and you have that singleness of purpose and you have that vision and you see yourself accomplishing, if the story that you're telling yourself is, I'm going to accomplish that. Once again, you see how these laws are all connected. If you're telling yourself that story, the universe is going to want to help you. However, it will stop helping you unless you take some action. And when you take action, it will start to give you some feedback. It will start to give you some mind flashes. It will start to create some circumstances that you can either predict or plan. Sometimes these mind flashes are known as intuition. You don't know necessarily where you got the idea from. It's the universe trying to help you. It's the universe remaining anonymous. No less a thinker than Einstein tells us, trust your intuition. Your intuition is everything. When you look at successful people, you'll see that this formula is always the same. The law of inspired action, what Napoleon Hill calls the sixth sense, it's always the same. It always happens. When you have that singleness of purpose, you will get inspired with ideas from anywhere. You won't, from everywhere. And like I say, it doesn't decide good or bad. It doesn't make judgments. If you're focused on one particular thing, the things that you see around you will become part of that focus. You'll connect them. Things that you pass by, like a billboard that you pass by 9 million times, when your focus changes and you have that singleness of purpose, that message from that billboard will say, my goodness, that connects to what I'm thinking about. That gives me an idea. These are the things that successful people tell you. When you have that singleness of purpose, the universe will help you. But you've got to take some action. And many times, the action that you want to take is not something that you would have logically thought of. It comes from your subconscious. When you think about something, you go to sleep, you're seeing the completed result that you want, the outcome that you desire. What happens is the universe, that's when the universe will go to work with you. And the time, excuse me, the times that you get these inspirational ideas are when you are in a relaxed state. You could be taking a shower. You can be watching the kids. You could be driving along the road. Whatever you're doing, you're in kind of a relaxed state. That is the time when the universe most frequently will give you a mind flash, give you an idea. That's when your intuition will come to the forefront. And I've discussed this before, but this is the law of inspired action, all right? So I'm gonna make this very brief, very short. These things are all connected. The law of divine oneness, we're all connected. The universe wants to help. The law of vibration, you gotta send out the right vibe. You have to be in a position to receive the vibe. The vibe that you send out is gonna be intense. It's a burning desire. It differentiates the one thought from the 60,000 thoughts. But you also have to give yourself some quiet thinking time, some relaxed time, and be alert when the universe gives you a mind flash or creates a circumstance. And sometimes the mind flash comes in bits and pieces and you have to assemble those pieces and put it together like a puzzle. Then there's the law of correspondence. The story that you tell yourself, if you say to yourself, oh, I could never do that, all right? Guess what? You're never gonna be able to do that. But if you see yourself, if you're excited, if you have the self-esteem, if you know that you can get that job done, the story that you tell yourself, once again, it's all connected. Of course, the law of attraction. Like attracts like. When you see something and you envision it in your mind, you will start to see other things around you that relate to that thing. Like attracts like. And of course, once again, what we talked about today, the law of inspired action. The law of inspired action is you've got to take the action and you will be, you'll get that mind flash, but you've got to move forward with it. Just thinking about it, dreaming it, is not going to get the job done. You've got to take steps forward. And the why because of that is the universe wants to be your partner. But the universe will not spend its time with you if you're not taking action. If you stop taking action, the universe says, oh, must just be a casual thought because I don't see anybody moving forward with it. So keep this in mind. This is, and once again, these are all connected. And because we will never end a meeting on a philosophical note, let's get out there, take some action, and charge! I'm Eli's dad.